Hello. Today we are going to use the previously described sculpture of pyramid to make a sculpture of a Pokemon Pikachu head. Inflate yellow balloon leaving about 4 inch flat tail. Twist the first about 1 inch bubble. Twist the chain of the next 4 about 3 inch bubbles. Lock both ends of the chain of the last 4 bubbles in one lock twist. We have made the base of the pyramid. Twist the chain of the next 2 about 2.5, maybe 2 inch bubbles. And then we lock both ends of the chain of the last 4 bubbles in one lock twist. So in this example, we use longer bubbles to make the base of the pyramid and the shorter bubbles to make the top of the pyramid. And now we twist the chain of the next 3 soft up to 1 inch bubbles. We are going to lock all ends of the last 3 bubbles in one lock twist to make the mouth. We can work the last 3 bubbles one by one or all together. It really doesn't matter in what order we lock the ends. Actually, we can use additional balloon to make the mouth bubbles. We use the pyramid as a base to make heads of different animals. So you can choose different color balloons to make the pyramid, and then we use different color balloon to make the mouth bubbles. Well, in this example, it's all yellow, so we try to use one balloon. I don't know why I spent so much time fixing these 3 bubbles. Well, anyway, it's done. Here's the front view, top view, and the side view. Twist the next 11th about 1 inch bubble. And now we have to lock both ends of the chain of the first 11 bubbles in one lock twist. We have made the back and the front of the pyramid. Now let's make the left and right side. Twist the next about 1 inch bubble. Lock both ends of the chain of the last 8 bubbles in one lock twist. Twist the 13th about 2 inch bubble. Lock both ends of the chain of the last 6 bubbles in one lock twist. Twist the 14th about 2 inch bubble. And now we have to lock the free end. And here's the one thing. As you can see in this example, I don't really make the lock. Just for the free end between bubbles, it would be enough. This way we save, well, at least couple seconds on making sculpture. Couple seconds here, couple seconds there, it all counts. But if the time not really problem for you, then you should definitely make the full lock like this. Now let's twist the 15th about 1 inch bubble. Lock both ends of the chain of the last 15 bubbles in one lock twist. Did you see what just happened? That's alright, we just have to tie the ends of bubbles back. Okay, once we tie ends of bubbles in one lock twist, we can cut off the rest of the balloon and tie off the end. Or we just can hide the end of the balloon between bubbles of the head. That's a good idea to do with small bubbles, of course. If you have long bubble at the end of the balloon, you can use it to represent the neck bubble. Alright, we have made the pyramid with mouth bubbles. Let's fix all bubbles in proper positions. Let's take a look. Here's the bottom view, the front view, and the top view. Now let's use black balloon to make the nose bubble. Let's use the end of the balloon to make the nose bubble. That's the way you make them the best round bubble. Stretch the end of the balloon couple times and then force the air to the end of the balloon. We have to make about thumbnail size bubble. Attach the black nose bubble between three small yellow bubbles that represents mouse. Here I'm making the final adjustment of the size of black bubble. And now we lock the end. Once we attach the black nose bubble, use scissors to cut off the rest of the balloon. Keep in mind we're going to use the rest of the black balloon a bit later to make eye bubbles. It is good practice to keep scrap balloons just for these occasions when you have to make one small bubble. Okay, let's fix the nose bubble properly. I like to place the black bubble, the nose bubble, on top of two yellow mouse bubbles. Okay, here's a top view of the head. And the next step, we will make ear bubbles. We'll place them right here. I'm going to use second yellow balloon to make ear bubbles. You can use scrap of yellow balloons to make the same. Let's force yellow balloon between bubbles of the head from the top and the back side of the head. Tie the nozzle of the second balloon between bubbles on the bottom side of the head. Twist about 4 or 5 inch long bubble. Don't make it too long, it should protrude about 2 inch above the top of the head. Cut off the rest of the balloon. I did it with my fingers, you can do it with scissors. Tie off the end. We have made one ear. We make the second ear working in the same fashion. In this example, we making ear bubbles after we already made the head. We could do it before when we were working on the head as well. I don't think it really makes big difference though. Okay, let's tie the end of the balloon between bubbles of the head on the bottom side. Now we twist the second ear bubble of the same size as we did the first ear bubble. And again, use scissors or your fingers to cut off the rest of the balloon and tie off the end. Fix all bubbles in proper positions. Well, it looks all right. There are some more work to do with ears, but let's make eye bubbles first. We are going to use scrap of black balloon to make two eye bubbles. In this example, I'm going to make eye bubbles bigger size than we made the nose bubble. Let's twist soft about 1 inch size bubble. Lock both ends of the first bubble in one lock twist. Before we lock it, let's check the size. It should be bigger than the nose bubble. Tie the ends to secure the bubble. Push the air about 2 inches away from the first bubble to make flat space between bubbles. Twist the second soft about 1 inch bubble. It should be the same size as the first black bubble. Lock both ends of the second black bubble in one lock twist. Cut off the rest of the balloon. Tie off the ends. Okay, we have made two eye bubbles. Also, instead of two small eye bubbles, we can use one big eye bubble to represent two eyes. Now let's attach eye bubbles to the head. Simply force eye bubbles between bubbles of the head on the front side of the head. Fix them in proper positions. That's it. It was simple. Let's use scissors to trim off ends of ear bubbles. And then we use a permanent black marker to paint ends of ear bubbles. I'm going to first play this part of the video clip. Congratulations, we have made head of Pokemon Pikachu. We can attach this head to different bodies. In this example, instead of body, I want to attach the head to simple three-fold head. Inflate yellow balloon. Attach the nozzle of this balloon at the bottom between bubbles of the head. Here you can take a closer look. Also, there is an even simpler way to make the hat. Simply tie the balloon in a knot, sort of. Yeah, just like that. Alright, let's make threefold hat. Twist the first about 3-inch bubble. Now we can measure the size of the hat. We'll just fold the balloon 3 times to measure size of next 3 bubbles. Twist the second bubble, twist the third bubble. The second and third bubble should be the size of the hat. Lock both ends of the chain of the last 2 bubbles. Twist the fourth soft about 1-inch bubble. Lock both ends of the fourth bubble in one lock twist. Twist the fifth bubble the same size as we twisted the second or third bubble. And lock both ends of the chain of the last 2 bubbles in one lock twist. The rest of the balloon is a tail. Congratulations, we have made the Pikachu hat. Here's the bottom view, the side view, the front view. Working in the same fashion, we can make many other different animals, cartoon characters. Just use the appropriate color balloons, different shape ears, and maybe change the size of bubbles to change shape of the head. This should be enough for this instruction. Have fun and happy twisting!